must be what? Glorified. Praise Jesus. Now the Son of Man is also a man, but he must be glorified. How? Through the grace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let me give you this revelation. When God created the Spirit, He gave the Spirit everything and gave Him the capacity to accommodate the Holy Spirit. When Jesus gives out the Holy Spirit and He says that I will send a helper, that is what He said. Now, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, who the world does not understand because it does not have Him, but you understand Him because you have Him. Praise the Lord. Jesus said, a little while longer, the world will not see me anymore, but you shall be seeing me in the real sense. According to the facts of the world, it is impossible. It is impossible for something to come there. You see it, and I fail to see it. Praise the Lord. The disciples asked Him, how shall it be? Whether the world will not see you, but we shall see you. How will it happen? Praise the Lord. I want to explain to you how it is going to happen. That the Spirit of God shall dwell in you. You will experience Him. You will produce Him. And also the world shall wonder. Jesus said,
yes,
the Spirit of the Lord, the Spirit of truth, will come to you and dwell in you, whom the world cannot understand. But you understand Him because He is in you. Praise the Lord. Amen. Jesus knew. Jesus prepared the apostles and the disciples in His preparation. He prepared them for this. And this one may die. He told them, do not lean on the body. Let the body die. When they accepted that, the soul also died. The desires of the soul also died. Amen. The desires of the body. When they were ready, and their hearts were ready to receive the Holy Spirit, that means that He sent them in the upper room. He started watering them. They prayed. They fasted. They sought for God. In those 40 days, He was watering them. There is something underneath. There is something underneath. The rain of the Holy Spirit was watering them. Was watering them. It was not watering this. It was not watering this. He was watering the Spirit. When time came, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of God, so that they were ready to accommodate Him. So He came with a mighty wave, and with a strong wind, that came from heaven and said, I'm calling where my sin is, where I must be sent, where I must be dwelled. He came with the fire and said, I must protect my sin with the fire. I must protect my sins with the fire.